Hey guys, Matt here today. We finally move on from 1 Timothy 4:1 through 5. It's easy to get lost in that. It's easy to want to stay there. And I like Timothy, we have to call out false teaching. Like Paul, we need to call them by name. I think we need to be careful of one thing though. Not to be known for what we're against, but yet to be known for what we're for. A very wise man, the man who writes the commentaries for the prison material, told me that. He said, if that's your call, you know, do it, but just don't be known for what you're against. I think there's wisdom in that, great godly wisdom. We can't be cowards, we can't be timid, we have to be bold, but that's just part of our ministry. That's part of what I feel is my ministry, but just part, not the whole thing. I don't just want to be known for what I'm against. Okay, so we move on into verse 6 through 8 here, and Paul tells Timothy how to be a good servant. This is awesome. He says, if you point these things out to the brothers, you will be a good minister of Christ Jesus, a good servant of Christ Jesus, brought up in the truths of the faith and of the good teaching that you have followed. The good teaching, not the bad doctrine, not the extra-biblical doctrine, but the good stuff, right? The good teaching that you have followed have nothing to do with godless myths and old wives' tales. Rather, train yourself up to be godly. Train yourself up to be godly. Listen to this next part, verse 8. For physical training has some value, yeah, but godliness, yeah, godliness has value for all things, holding promise for both the present life and the life to come. That's amazing. We're going to look at that. This is awesome. So Paul starts out telling Timothy how to be a good servant to Christ Jesus, right? So for all of us who want to be good servants of Christ Jesus, this is a good time to perk up our ears and listen, because Paul says, if you tell them these things, you will be a good servant, a good minister of Christ Jesus. What are these things? I can only do it with one hand, sorry. What are these things, right? Well, remember, this isn't just talking about false teaching, I don't think, because when Paul wrote this letter, there wasn't chapter 1, chapter 2, it was just one long letter. There were no chapter breaks or verse breaks, right? So Paul says, tell them these things. Point out these things to the brother. These things are, the first thing we see Paul telling Timothy is to charge them to not teach any other doctrine. Charge those false teachers, Timothy. Charge. It's a military term. It's a powerful term. And by the way, Timothy, this charge, it comes from love, right? What does that mean? Well, we should always want false teachers to repent and come to the knowledge of the truth. If we practice church discipline and people get kicked out of the church, it should be based in love. It should be so they repent and come back, right? Or so they repent and get born again in the first place. Maybe that's a better way of saying it. And by the way, Timothy, this love comes from a pure heart and a good conscience and a sincere faith. Quite the contrary to what the false teachers were coming from. They weren't coming from love. There's nothing loving about dragging people back under the law. That's a trick of the enemy. It's the oldest trick in the book. It's from doctrines of demons. It's from the pit of hell, right? So remind them, Timothy, remind them that these false teachers promote speculation rather than stewardship that comes from faith. And this speculation always ends in the same old ditch, the ditch of vain discussion. We see it all the time. I see it on YouTube all the time. Vain discussion. Leading people away from godliness. Don't do it, he says, Timothy. Don't do it. By the way, Timothy, you are to teach the church how they ought to act. You are to teach how one ought to act in the church of God. That's 1 Timothy 3:15, right? Okay, well, how do they act? Well, first of all, we got to remember, Timothy, that it's God's house. We can't just do church any old way we want. And if we want to see God active and alive, we got to choose elders biblically, choose deacons biblically, right? Men and women should have their proper roles, right? Men must lead prayer, not afraid to raise holy hands, not be angry. We should pray for kings and all those in high places and authority. Why? So we can live quiet, godly lives in Christ Jesus, dignified in every way, Timothy. That's what Paul says, right? And by the way, you, church, Paul says to Timothy, remind them that you are the church and you are the pillar and the buttress of this truth. What is the truth? Well, It's that Jesus Christ is the only way. It's that it's this mystery of godliness, right? That which is Christ in you, the mystery of the faith, Christ in you, the hope of glory. Remember, you're the pillar and the buttress holding this gift, which was unwrapped for Paul, called the mystery of faith, which is Christ in you, the hope of glory. And you are the stewards of this, so take care of it. Do church properly, right? And another one of these things was what we just read, that Paul says the Spirit expressly says, that's right now. This isn't something Paul heard from somebody else. The Spirit expressly says that in some time, in the latter times, some will abandon the faith, following deceiving spirits, things taught by demons, doctrines of demons. Such teachings come through hypocritical liars whose consciences are seared. Timothy, don't be surprised when this happens. Church, us, today, don't be surprised when this happens. It will happen. So, if you point these things out to the brothers, you will be a good servant. Okay? Paul tells Timothy how to be a good servant. He's telling us how to be a good servant. Take care of God's house. Take care of God's church. Be good stewards of this mystery of the faith, which is Christ in you, the hope of glory. You know, make sure we do church right. Call out false teachers. I'm going to stop there, and then next I'm going to get into the next verse, which is training yourself up. This is powerful, powerful stuff. I'll be right back. Peace.